Sheldon's small boat was tossed to and fro. His boat quickly capsized. Poor Sheldon, oh no!
Here in this room behind me is an enchanted land full of mysterious sea creatures. We're here at the Busy Bees Daycare Center in White Bear Lake, Minnesota, where these kids are getting the first look at the adventures of Sheldon.
He's a blue blob with missing parts. Why does Sheldon the monster have only one eye and one arm?
Sheldon just kind of came up out of nowhere, really. I mean, just the video competition, I was shooting ideas back and forth with someone else, and we just kind of thought of, what if we had this little cute monster that went on an adventure?
Sheldon is the brainstorm of college student and author Brianna Harrelson, who first developed the character as part of this entry into Century College's annual video competition.
Sheldon doesn't really talk too much. He doesn't have any real lines in the book. He just has a little thought bubble.
Brianna does talk, so one day while chatting with classmate Mike Berglund during an audio class, she showed him her video about Sheldon. With Mike being a budding artist, it didn't take long for the two to decide to turn the video into a children's book.
As you can see here, you know, it's just basically a circle, a half circle here, a circle for the eye, and a little kind of weird shape for the arm. So it's a real easy draw.
The storyline is also basic. Sheldon goes on an adventure with only an eye and an arm. He finds another eye and arm, which help him meet a beautiful mermaid named Agatha. But then an octopus-looking creature called a kraken tries to grab her. But Sheldon gets involved and saves her. Agatha gives Sheldon a kiss, and now he has a mouth.
We're going to be reading The Adventures of Sheldon.
Brianna and Mike recently held a book reading party at Century's Busy Bees Daycare Center.
The kraken was big, big, orange, and tall. And Sheldon was blue, blue and so small.
Sheldon was a hit. To prepare for the special visit from Brianna and Mike, Busy Bees director Terry Cross had decorated the center in proper Sheldon decor. All the kids made their favorite characters on paper and in Play-Doh.
Okay, so these are little critters that your kids made.
Yep, they all wanted to make, you know, Sheldons or Krakens. So they ended up making what their little characters, and they all wanted the eyes.
She blew him a kiss. She giggled and waved.
To get the book off the ground, Mike enlisted the help of Tom Mabey.
When I spotted Mike 8 years ago, I knew there was a lot of talent there already. And he expanded his talent coming here to Century. But when he came to me and he said, Tom, you gotta look at this.
Of course, marketing the book would also be important. So Brianna and Mike brought in fellow classmate, Deborah Krupka.
I thought it was very colorful. It was creative. I fell in love with Sheldon. The characters in it, all the illustration and everything. I knew Mike had worked on it so much. And I just gravitated towards it.
A special Sheldon cake was brought in, and each child got their picture taken with the big blue monster.
What was it like to see the reaction of all the kids to Sheldon?
I loved it. I loved seeing the kids get excited about seeing this character and seeing the book and, you know, talking about the story and telling me what's going to happen next.
We made art projects all week. They loved it. They were thinking that Sheldon's a superhero. We made this giant kraken, and they would go run up to him and say, oh, I'm a superhero, and they'd, you know, pull their muscles and they'd say, I'm gonna get you, kraken. And so they were playing the role of Sheldon really well.
The goal is to turn Sheldon into a multimedia interactive phenomenon.
And it appeals to girls as well as boys, but, you know, Sheldon's kind of appeals to the boys, and the girls love the mermaid.
To Mike and Brianna, The Adventures of Sheldon isn't just a book. It's hard work and a dream to see how far a big blue blob can go.
What would you say is the lesson of The Adventures of Sheldon?
You can be brave. You know, you don't have to be anything terribly special to be brave and do what's right.
Life to the Max is brought to you by LifeTouch, photography for a lifetime.